And now performing the national anthem, the Glenel Madrigals and Choir Seniors under the direction of Miss Natalie Cardillo.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we
Good day. At this time, we'd like to recognize our elected officials who are joining us virtually and sending best wishes and congratulations to the class of 2020, Senator Katie Fry Hester. We're also delighted to have County Executive Dr. Calvin Ball, our Superintendent Dr. Michael Moderano, and Board of Education member Jennifer Swickward-Mallo with us, and look forward to hearing their remarks later in our ceremony. Thank you.
Good morning, students and families. Hi, I'm Andrew, and I have Valerie here to help sign this speech to convey this message to a greater audience. Words that usually come to mind when we think about graduation are accomplishments, memories, goodbyes, and completion. And while many of these things are what you may be feeling now, I believe that graduation is about the beginnings. Both the past beginnings and future beginnings are what I think about. And though we may be separated physically, class of 2020, let's be excited, let's be joyful, and let's show that gladiator pride as we reflect on our time at Glenel. I'll always remember being in the auditorium during freshman orientation, and the teachers literally gave us a fashion show of the school dress code. It was in that moment that I got a brief taste of the humor and welcoming environment that Glenel wants to offer. Freshman year gave us a sense of realness. Realness in the sense that we are no longer the center of the universe. All our lives, we've been coddled by our teachers, being told how important we are and that we're all winners. But then high school. In high school, we quickly learned and were told that we suck at many things and that we are in fact not the best at everything. But behind this rude awakening lies a genuine care and encouragement from our teachers. Teaching us at high school is and will always be a place for growth and improvement. Sophomore year, the year that most of us took our first APs and started to drive, which I'm sure that some of your parents were more excited about than you were. Sophomore year is like the middle child, often forgotten, but has some sort of special quality that makes it so lovable. And despite having the mental breakdown every chemistry class, school was going great. We learned how to navigate the halls better. We knew what lunch was what. Life was pretty great. Then, junior year. Just that infamous, oh, junior year's hard. It's the most stressful. I was, to say the least, a little skeptical. Man, I was wrong. And not just schoolwork being harder and grades being more important and SAT and ACT, but there was all this talk about the future, whatever that means. All of the painful hours just sitting in a whole class period doing Naviance surveys, all the personality tests and the 80 question interest survey. But as hard as it was, we got through it. And sadly, it became a matter of not realizing how fast the time goes by. Senior year, finally, we all told ourselves we have to make the most with what little time we have. And I think we can all agree that that little time we have has been cut down significantly. And it's just beginning to hit me that the seeing my friends in the hallways or the simplest hellos from my teachers have all been taken for granted. And it's all these little things that I never realized that I would miss so much. My experience at Glenelg has definitely been one of you get what you put in. And it's hard not to get a lot out of Glenelg with the many, many opportunities to get involved from clubs like FCA, SGA, the other SGA, Key Club, and the countless others in between. And from our arts departments, orchestra, band, choir, theater, and dance. I believe our class loved to get involved, partly because of Mr. Burton. On day one, I still remember Mr. Burton always saying, get involved, get involved, get involved. Even if you don't have a club, make a club and just get involved. And our class, no matter who you are, love to do things together in community. We killed it at every theme day for homecoming, all the way from Under the Sea to Peter Pan to Rocking the 90s and finally Beach Day. We're the class that set the new record of crabs eaten at the senior crab feast. And not to toot my own horn or anything, but Grace Meisel and I have set that new 26 and a half crabs each record. So juniors, if you're watching, come at us. But in all seriousness, I'll always take to heart that we're not just a class full of well-rounded individuals. We are a well-rounded class full of exceptional individuals who are gonna do amazing things after high school. And so as I reflect on all the past beginnings we have shared, I am excited for the future beginnings that we are all about to embark on. And a little birdie on the announcements once told us, once a gladiator, always a gladiator. Work hard.
Be kind.
Be loyal.
Be honest.
Maintain your sense of humor. You'll always need that.
Keep your body and mind healthy and strong.
And lastly, stay true to yourself and others. Class of 2020, I am so happy. Congratulations. You deserve this day and everything to come. Thank you.
My name is Hallie Cooley, and I am a proud member of the class of 2020. I have the distinct pleasure of introducing the Glenelg High School administration. Mr. David Burton, principal of Glenelg High School. Miss Mary Cherry, assistant principal, Glenelg High School. Mr. Patrick Krause, assistant principal, Glenelg High School. Dr. William Neugebauer, assistant principal, Glenelg High School. Mr. Daniel Sageman, athletic and activities manager, Glenelg High School.
My name is Roger Kondwa, and I am the proud member of the class of 2020. I have the distinct pleasure of introducing the Glenelg High School counselors, who will be reading the names of our 306 wonderful graduates. Dr. Stephen Burnett, instructional team leader and counselor. Mrs. Kelly Brandt, counselor. Mrs. Carolyn Devlin, counselor. Mrs. Mindy Hirsch, counselor.
Hello, class of 2020, family, friends, teachers. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Sydney Rapoli, and I'm beyond grateful to be speaking on behalf of a group of students that are some of the most talented and hardworking people I know. First, I'd like to start by giving you all a huge congratulations because we made it. All 4 years from the first day we walked into the doors of Glen Elle, we've been counting down the days until today. A ceremony that marks the end of an era and a new beginning filled with opportunities for all of us. Even though this ceremony is not taking place in the traditional setting of Merryweather, I'm so thankful we're still all able to get together to commemorate our vast accomplishments. I consider myself extremely lucky to have been able to call Glen Elle my second home these last 4 years. The friends I've made, the clubs I've joined, the teachers, and every other connection I've made within the walls of Glen Elle and our community has made me into the person I am today. Besides our stellar academics, we have some of the best sports teams in the county. We follow our teams, cheering and supporting them through their wins and their losses, all the while becoming a tighter-knit family throughout the seasons. To me, the craziest thing about today is that it's one big glorified goodbye. Today is the day we not only say goodbye to those we've known since we were 5 years old, but it's a goodbye to the comfort of our community and familiarity we have established with each other and grown so accustomed to. For me, one of my biggest regrets is not branching out more. Though I'm extremely outgoing, I look out on the videos of your faces today and I see so many I missed out on getting to know. But even if you don't know my name and I don't know yours, I hope we can share in the camaraderie that we've made it through these last 4 years together. We all sat through the same assemblies and school-sponsored events and took challenging courses that caused us to question ourselves. And even if I wasn't sitting right next to you, we experienced it together. And that's what matters. But I don't want to focus only on the goodbyes, but rather a future of hellos we have to come. No matter where you're off to, whether it be the workforce, some form of college, serving your country, traveling, or simply taking a break, I want you to take some of the life lessons you've learned your last 4 years and put them to the best of use. We're going off into the real world, guys, and there are so many new and exciting opportunities awaiting us in our futures, and I hope you're all just as excited as I am. But always remember, no matter what happens, life is going to be what you make it. If you live your life afraid to take risks, afraid to make new connections, and afraid to open yourself up, you won't be experiencing the world. You'll just be closing yourself off from a vast expanse of opportunity. So I ask you this, and I don't think it's much to ask, but I want you to open yourself up. I want you to be open to meeting new faces and open to new experiences, because what awaits us out there is unlike anything we've experienced before, and it's finally our time. And with these departing words, I wish you the best, class of 2020. Please feel so proud and accomplished of everything you've done. Thank you so much, and the best is yet to come.
Hello, fellow gladiators, families, and friends. My name is Kabir Satija, and I'm a proud member of Glen Elle High School's class of 2020. I'm really sorry, but I'm going to have to go off on a complete tangent from what Sydney was talking about. It's going to seem completely unrelated and honestly really nerdy, but just hear me out for a second. There's this thing called the law of diminishing marginal utility. Pretty much what this law says is that as you consume more of anything, you gain less from each additional unit. So when you're eating pizza, the 10th slice doesn't taste nearly as good as the first two did. For the past few months, I've been struggling to think of a time when this law didn't hold true. It makes sense. It seems like it works for pretty much everything. But as the last few weeks of our senior year have dwindled down, I think I finally found something it doesn't hold true for. Time. In middle school and the start of high school, I couldn't wait to graduate. I looked at my senior brother and his friends with envy. They were getting ready to graduate, to start the next chapter of their lives. But since quarantine started, something has changed. I just wish we had a little more time left in high school. I'm still incredibly thrilled about the future, don't get me wrong, but I wish I had a little more time to spend with my classmates and friends. In the words of Andrew Bernard, I wish there was a way to know you're in the good old days before you've actually left them. But I don't want to end on a note of melancholy. Even though it's virtual, this is still our graduation. And graduating isn't the end. It's just the beginning. As we continue with our lives, we'll be well equipped for whatever lies ahead. Whether we realize it or not, our experiences at Glen Elle have shaped us. And as we become successful, We will remember these experiences. Today, take a moment to thank everyone who's helped you. Your family, friends, teachers, classmates, everyone. Because honestly, the people around us shape us. They prepare us for success. They help us through failures. And most importantly, they're always there for us. And well, I think we can all say that if the people around us shape us, we've been very lucky to go to Glen Elle High School. Thank you.
Please welcome Howard County Executive Dr. Calvin Ball.
Hello, class of 2020. To all our graduates, let me join in the chorus of congratulations today. You have worked hard to make all your educators, families, and all of Howard County very proud. To all your family members and loved ones, thank you for your steadfast support of our graduates. As each of your names are called, you are joined in spirit by everyone who supported you, who provided for you, and who loved you throughout your life. Obviously, today looks a bit different than we may have imagined. And while this virtual celebration was not part of the original plan, consider how incredible it is that now so many loved ones from around the world can tune in and share in this recognition of your accomplishments. A word that has come up frequently in the past couple of months is perseverance. Perseverance has defined this moment, but it's been constant since the beginning of time. Perseverance may look different to everyone, but it continues to be a force that pushes humanity forward. In the past 12 years, you've certainly learned of Abraham Lincoln's perseverance, whose advice stands true today when he said, "Always bear in mind that your own resolution to succeed is more important than any other one thing." There's the perseverance of scientists who, despite campaigns against their findings and some stubborn politicians, continue to inform our global population about climate change. And how can we forget the perseverance of our ancestors? Those who fought for freedom, for the right to vote, for peace, or for justice. Here and around our world, there's the perseverance of teachers who have rapidly adapted their methods and embraced new technology and new ways to help teach and help ensure that you can learn. There's the perseverance of you, our 2020 seniors. Your stories didn't start 2 months ago. They didn't even start 12 years ago. But you've persevered through grammar, times tables, and reading aloud in front of a whole class. You've persevered through new schools and new friends, learning how to play an instrument or trying out for a sport. You've persevered through trigonometry or geometry or one of those math classes that has more letters than numbers. You persevered through the uncertainty of your final semester and made it here today. Each of these moments where you persisted through challenges or changes have prepared you for whatever is on the horizon. And I have no doubt that you will all find much success in the future and make our world a better place. Today, we celebrate you, your incredible accomplishments, and your ability to always persevere. Congratulations, class of 2020, you did it!
Hailing from the humble town of Covert, Michigan, Principal David P. Burton grew up in one of the first integrated school systems in the entire nation. As a first-generation college-bound student, Burton originally chose to study biology at Oakland University, where he took advantage of his evening school schedule to become a substitute teacher in his community. Soon, this small side job quickly blossomed into a real passion for Burton, as he started to relate to the aspirations and struggles of his students. Surrounded by those who who believed that crime and entertainment were the only avenues to success. Byrne would like to thank his mentors for teaching him how to use his leadership and personal development to make a real impact on his community. Byrne then moved across the country to work at Howard University and later went on to become a teacher, assistant principal, and principal in Prince George's County before coming to Howard County. Despite having the displeasure of being a Steelers fan, Principal Byrne has always had a passion for connecting with his community. Mr. Byrne loves learning about the progress and experiences of those around him and enjoys seeing his students overcome their struggles and aspirations and become successful. Moreover, as a lifelong learner, an avid supporter of the power of education, he sees education as the great equalizer of this country and as a resource to rely upon. He always stresses the need to learn from others and to adapt yourself without compromising your values. And now, please welcome your very proud principal, Mr. David P. Byrne.
Greetings, members of the Board of Education, Superintendent Dr. Michael Moderano, central office leaders, members of the faculty, honored guests, parents, family, friends, and most importantly, members of the graduating class of 2020. I want to welcome you to the 62nd annual and first ever virtual commencement ceremony for Glen Elm High School. As parents and educators well know, it is not appropriate to have favorites, like favorite children or favorite students. However, I must admit, I have a special connection with the class of 2020. You see, 4 years ago, I became the proud principal of Glen Elm High School. I don't believe things happen randomly. Instead, I believe there is a purpose to everything that transpires in this life. I believe it was destiny that brought me to Glen Elm High School the summer of 2016. It was also destiny that brought this eclectic group of talented graduates to Glen Elm's doorsteps that same year. I was instantly drawn to you, class of 2020, because I knew we would have 4 years to learn and grow together. Over the past 4 years, you have truly embodied our Glen Elm pride of personal responsibility, integrity, determination, and empathy. And I have personally witnessed you transform from unsure freshmen to the confident young men and women you are today. And I couldn't be any more proud of you. There is a well-known mantra that states, hindsight is 20/20. This phrase suggests that it is easy for one to look back at a situation or event that occurred in the past and have a clearer understanding once it is passed with, quote unquote, 20/20 or perfect vision. Looking back on 2020, there is much for you to reflect on, graduates. There were some extreme highs, like celebrity chef Gordon Ramsay, who, after being touched by stories of resiliency, visited historic downtown Ellicott City to help local business owners rebuild hope and infrastructure in the aftermath of catastrophic floods in years past. There also were some devastating losses that took all of our breath away and reminded us of the sacredness of life. This past year, GIFs ruled how we communicated with one another, and TikToks took over much of how you spent your free time. But beyond these highlights, nothing comes close to the defining moment in time that we all experienced and are still experiencing as a collective universe. The global pandemic has changed everything we know about life and connection. No one knows this better than you, class of 2020. As a result of COVID-19, your senior year of school was abruptly cut short without notice or opportunity for you to experience closure. You lost the gift of spending time with your friends, were robbed of memory-making events like prom, your senior class picnic, and other traditional rites of passage. Many athletes were not able to complete their final year of high school competition. College tours and admitted student visits were conducted online or canceled altogether, and each of you were forced to socially distance from your friends, loved ones, and strangers alike. I'm quite certain this past year looked nothing like you expected, class of 2020. Brian Tracy once said, "You cannot control what happens to you, but you can control your attitude toward what happens to you. In doing so, you will be mastering change rather than allowing it to master you." In the world of psychology, the ability to change our perspective about a stressful situation in order to make a more positive position about our life and circumstances is known as reframing. This powerful act of shifting your mindset by pausing to intentionally take in the world through a different lens can change your experiences and ultimately the trajectory of your entire life. A wise proverb states, when we change the way we look at things, the things we look at change. As you look back on this past year, graduates, I invite you to look back on it with a new lens, a more empowered lens. Rather than seeing scarcity and lost opportunities, I encourage you to see the positives, the possibilities, the hope, and the potential. We all know how hard you wish for a few snow days each year, right? Just think, class of 2020, you experienced the longest snow day break in the history of school. You were able to sleep in a bit rather than waiting at bus stops and starting cold car engines on dark mornings while you were still half asleep. You had an abundance of time to reconnect with your families, to work on puzzles, go on walks, start new hobbies, and of course, make more TikToks. You had opportunities to honor frontline workers by making masks and collecting personal protective equipment to help keep them safe. You exercised social responsibility by staying home, thus helping to keep fellow citizens, including our most vulnerable populations, safe and healthy. And right around the time you would have typically started experiencing senioritis, spring brought you the unique opportunity to become digital learning trailblazers, fulfilling your remaining academic requirements outside of the traditional brick and mortar school building. Yes, there are many parts of the typical senior year that you missed, but as a recent meme states, high school is a lot like toilet paper. You only miss it once it's gone. Sonia Riccardi once said, accept what is, let go of what was, and have faith in what will be. When you look back on your senior year, graduates, my hope and prayer is that your hindsight is 2020 vision will allow you to see clearly the wonderfully unique opportunity it was to be a member of the graduating class of 2020. Yes, there's no other class that has your story, and I can't wait to see what the future holds for you as you create your next chapters. Now, my sense is I've gone on long enough, and you are eager for me to wrap this up so you can get busy doing the Tootsie Slide at your virtual graduation parties.
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you the passion. It's a thriller in a track. Where we from?
Oh, I'm sorry, I got caught up myself. In closing, please know, class of 2020, that you will be greatly missed, not just by me, but by the entire Glenel staff. It has been an honor and privilege to serve as your principal for the past 4 years. Congratulations and best of luck to all of you. I now have the distinct pleasure to introduce to you a special guest. No, it's not Drake, but perhaps the next best thing. Our special guest is a graduate of Glenel High School. Caroline Bowman graduated from Glenel in 2006 and went on to complete a Bachelor's of Fine Arts in Musical Theater at Penn State University. Following her passion has led Caroline to success in the fine arts. Some of her career highlights include being cast in the ensemble of Wicked on Broadway and joining the original cast of Kinky Boots, which won the Tony for Best Musical. She has also held leading roles in Evita and currently stars as Elsa in the North American tour of Frozen the Musical. please join me in welcoming Glenel alum, Caroline Bowman.
Hello, Glenel graduates. My name is Caroline Bowman, and I graduated Glenel in 2006. And I wanted to sing a song for you that's very special to me for a number of reasons, but one of them being I sang this song at my graduation. And it also is a song from my very first Broadway show, Wicked. Now, before I sing it, I just want to tell you how excited I am for you, how proud I am of you, and how much love I am sending to you during this time. It is so exciting, no matter how it may look. This is all so exciting, and you should be so proud of yourself. I also wanted to share with you 6 rules to live by. Now, these rules are from another musical I did on Broadway called Kinky Boots. And I believe that if you live your life by these rules, you really cannot go wrong. 1, pursue the truth. 2, learn something new. 3, accept yourself and you'll accept others too. 4, let love shine. 5, let pride be your guide. And 6, you change the world when you change your mind. Congratulations. I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. I like a ship blown
legacy drawn by inviting the one who can say if I've been changed for the better. I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I knew you, because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Thank you, Caroline, for sharing your talents and inspiring words with our graduates. Now let's get to it, everyone. Ms. Mallow and Dr. Monterano, as principal of Glendale High School, I hereby certify that the members of the class of 2020 have met all the requirements for graduation as set forth by the Howard County Public School System and the Maryland State Department of Education. They are eligible to receive a Maryland High School diploma, a certificate of completion, certificate of attendance, or certificate of achievement. I am now pleased to turn this virtual graduation ceremony over to our wonderful superintendent, Dr. Michael J. Monterano.
Greetings, and I want to begin by saying congratulations to the class of 2020. You have persevered academically for over 12 years, and I am so proud of you and confident that you are ready for the next chapter of your life. You have achieved your goals both inside the classroom and outside the classroom, all while displaying and exhibiting solid character. Ultimately, who you are as a person will determine your lifelong success, fulfillment, and happiness. Having strong character involves hard work, perseverance, and grit. It means you have resilience, passion, and determination. Most of all, good character means always reaching down to give others a hand up. I commend the positive attitude and level of resilience that you have displayed, especially during these last several months. You have shown truly exceptional character. Class of 2020, I am in awe of your spirit and tenacity. Your optimistic and hopeful spirit serves as a model for all who interact with you. One of my favorite poets is Robert Frost, and his poem, The Road Not Taken, is my favorite. Its words have a poignancy that is most symbolic and relevant for this time. The final stanza of this poem reads as follows. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. To you as graduates, you have been on the road less traveled. I encourage you to stay on that path and forge your own road. Your chosen path should be one that leads to your fulfillment and happiness. Capitalizes on all you can to forge a future that will make a difference for others and helps to define a new and brighter future for humankind. Your diploma gives you the opportunity to truly make change in the world. As we grapple with the social-emotional impacts of the pandemic that may have forever changed our daily lives, we have recently witnessed another senseless killing of an African-American, George Floyd. It is important that we acknowledge this event, reflect on the hurt and pain we are feeling, and resolve together to do our part to eradicate hate, condemn violence, and stand up to acts of racism within our own communities. The great writer James Baldwin said it best, "Not everything that is faced can be changed, but nothing can be changed until it is faced." The best way for us to move forward is to face it head on, talk about it, and take actions that prevent this from happening again. I implore you to lead with vulnerability and empathy. Be change leaders for justice and create peaceful opportunities in spaces for people to share and heal together. The only way to eradicate hate is to lead with love, care, and compassion. If I can foreshadow our future, you, my beautiful students, are my hope for better days ahead and a better society. Be gentle and be kind. Be patient and persistent. Be other-centered and lead with equity as your core value. Be empathic, caring, and compassionate. Be upstanders, not bystanders. Be agents of change and be the love in the world, because love is the force that can illuminate and transcend all of humankind. You have an amazing opportunity and have a view like none who have come before you. Your perspective will be electrifying. Your generation will be known as the ones who truly changed the trajectory of our future. Choose to take the road less traveled and make the difference that your journey along the road will reveal. To the class of 2020, I wish you love, joy, and most of all, happiness. Congratulations. Next, I would like to welcome a member of the Howard County Board of Education to say a few words.
Today is a celebration of all that you have learned in the last 13 years. It's a recognition of your hard work, the dogged determination you've shown, the knowledge you have gained to go out into the world and be a successful adult. As the last few months have dramatically altered your education, your lives, and your dreams, I thought of this quote from author Jason Reynolds. Dreams don't have times, deadlines, and aren't always in straight lines. Since kindergarten, you have likely learned how to read, how to add and subtract, about cells and plants, about beautiful poems, and gut-wrenching coming-of-age stories, how to solve for equations, how to persuade others when writing, and about how the different branches of government work. If you've had a case of senioritis, you likely thought your learning was done mid-December. But as March folded into April and April tore through May, you have learned so much more than you likely ever bargained for. During the novel coronavirus pandemic, you have learned about how important your friends are, how challenging it is to stay home, sequestered from school and the classroom. You've learned about viruses and the science of how a contagion spreads. You may have learned about unemployment and how the machinery of government and bureaucracy works, and in some cases, does not work at all. You may have learned about hunger in your community or even in your home. With this knowledge, you likely built skills of navigating uncharted waters and of problem solving. You might have developed resiliency, empathy, or new ways of successfully coping with loss. In just the last week, with the murder of George Floyd, you probably learned about racism, policing, and civil unrest. We have seen unfathomable heartbreak and conflicting narratives. In the last week, we have seen a woman in New York use her privilege to falsely accuse a Black man. Time will tell what we have learned from the last week and the last couple months, but it's my hope that you take all that you have learned in the last 13 years and continue to learn beyond HCPSS. And continue to grow to become better humans and better adults. And finally, as you pursue those dreams that I mentioned earlier, despite all the twists and turns that the journey may take, know that you can and have succeeded. Families, at this time, please join me in honoring the class of 2020 as we now recognize each of our graduates.
Omotoyosi Saheed Charles Abu. Charles Maynard Actis. Franklin James Actis. Riley David Alquist. Kayla Alyssa Allison. Julie Ann Amos, Zachary Carl Amos, Callie Elizabeth Anderson, Kyle Marcellus Anderson, Rachel Kristen Anderson, Meredith Elise Arterburn, Nathan James Baker, Priya Sanjay Kumar Varaya, Isabella Dare Marie Beaumont, Taylor Marie Berry, Shiza Fatima Bhatti, Sierra Michelle Bowman, Carson Anthony Bowser, Brianna Ashanti Boykin, Robert Winston Brewer, Amy Atkins Brinster, Claire Redding Brinster, Logan Zachary Bruner, Joseph Andrew Bruzek, Edward Richard Bird Jr., Megan Grace Caffey, Stephen Mark Callis, Clayton Lee Kapanos, Olivia Nicole Carey, Benjamin Daniel Carney, Jackson Reed Carstea, Shane Andrew Carter, Taylor Ashley Carter, Madeline Elise Cassidy, Ryan Joseph Colley, Andrew Wanchang Cho, Sophia Rose Cicchetti, Daniel Arthur Clark, Casey James Clifford, Colin Joseph Clifford, Luke Kamahaho Cord, Tiffany Renee Coyle, Allison Grace Louise Conaway, Grant Spencer Considine, Jennifer Elise Cook, Caitlin Renee Costella, Christian David Kunzeman, Nathan Ryan Curtis, Thomas Russell Curtis Jr., Christine Nguyen Dang, Carmela Marie D'Antuono, Audrey Okorfa Darte, Hannah Wu Data, Eleanor Elizabeth Davis, Lisbeth Sally Loretta Davis, Mason Alexander Davis, Matthew Patrick Davis, Liam Raymond Day, Ignacio Martin DeSande, Felicia Denise Demby, Zachary John Devlin, Tristan Garrett Dewey, Matthew Luciano DeFranco, Cody Remington Dixon, Chloe Lejen Dressel, Kyle Aiden Dry, Benjamin Matthew Degnan, Kyle James Duncan, Logan Alexander Duncan, Molly Claire Dustin, Ava Rebecca Detro, Maya Ellen Eisenberg, Taylor Andrew Eisentrout, Devika Sumish Elakara, Elda Miriam Elias,
Stephanie Marie Faraci, Elizabeth Marie Figge, Cody James Ferguson, Mackenzie Marie Ferguson, Kelsey Grace Flavin, Kyle Thomas Foster, Preston Riley Foster, Zach Gabriel Michael Guimero, Bronwyn Jade Gallagher, Andrew Michael Gates, Sophie Louise Gay, Ian Myers Guyman, Trevor Joseph George, McKenna Lynn German, Abigail Chase Gillespie, Caroline Elizabeth Glassman, Ella Marie Glazier, Ryan Cole Goff, Matthew William Gower, Ian Michael Grisbian, Sebastian Taylor Gu, Daniel Lewis Guerrero Martin, Jorge Carlos Guerra Rodriguez,
Annalise Elizabeth Hammond,
Ellen Elizabeth Henderson, Mackenzie Elise Henson, Claire Lynn Herbolt, Mackenzie Christine Harith, Elizabeth Ann Hessen, Eric Dean Hicks, Grace Caitlin Hills, Hannah Ashley Hills, Anna Charlotte Hintz, Jenna Allison Hirsch, Bailey Teresa Hoke, Eliza Suzanne Hoflich, Catherine Elizabeth Hoffman, Alexander Ethan Huang, Brianna Marie Hughes, Christopher Joseph Hume, Lydia Jane Perrin, Jenna Jia Yuan Ayalungo, Nicole Dion East, Matthew Rodney Jenkins, Christopher David Johnson, Abigail Beverly Jones, John Thomas Jones, Ridgely Elijah Jones, Neha Reddy Cuttengory, David Patrick Kelly, Mitchell Scott Kemp Jr. Sarah Christian Kemp. Kaya Marie Kennedy. Thomas Bentley Kern III. Ermina Mahmood Khan. Jasmine Hyun Kim. Kirsten Nicole King. Jonathan Glenn Pinlock. Julie Marie Klein. Samantha Eileen Knoll. Haley Jean Cooley. Alexis Lee Caminos. Mohith Thai Kanduru. Maria Violet Kutsaharis. Noah Ronald Kowalczyk. Grant Maddox Kramer. Ilham Fatima Bakani. Bianca Sarah Lamptey Mills. Catherine Joy Laporte. Alexander Michael Lawson. Connor James Leard. Matthew Ryan Levitt. Jennifer Lee. Matthew Kangson Lee. Charles George Limbach. Catherine Alexis Lewis. Danny Sun Liu. Madeline Eve Livensbarger. Hadia Loden. Aiton Michael Long. Andreas Alejandro Lopez Campos. Maxwell Allen Liu. Annabella Virginia Ludwig. Brendan Matthew Lutz.
Grace Jane Meisel. Danish Ahmed Malek. Madison Jean Maloney. Valerie Hartwick Markle. Lakin Elizabeth Marshall. Hayden Nicholas Martinick. Anna Lee Masterman. Evangelos Christos Mavronis. Liliana Rose Emby Malurk. Liam Patrick McCarthy. Austin John Meyer. Grace Elizabeth Meissner. Catherine Trust Malesko. Eric Daniel Mendez. Alexis Jane Miles. Cole Michael Miller. Emily Rose Miller. Kylie Rose Miller. Morgan Elizabeth Miller. Ashir Asim Mir. Amar Asim Mir. Dominic Francesco Mirabile. Kyle Ibarra Murano. Paul William Moon. Lauren Kelsey Morale. Ryan Nicholas Moreland. Hayden Riley Moreno. James Michael Murbach. Matthew Paul Murphy. Ryan Patrick Murphy. Morgan Ann Murray. Madeline Rose Myers. Robin Michelle Neal. Cedric Hans Nelson. Zachary Jacob Nelson. Preston Fee Nugent. Janice Alicia Niv. Ashley Nicole O'Byrne. Jamie Ariel O'Connell. Jessica Nicole O'Connell. Jason Favor Chukwumaobi Okoria. Courtney Elizabeth Ott. Faith Sue Pack. Jane Sujin Park. Sheehan Park. Courtney Renee Parks. Grace Anna Perry. Rebecca Marie Pasquino. Philip Michael Patchen. Akash Rajan Patel. Anami Shailesh Patel. Cameron Elizabeth Payne. Michael Dylan Pierce. Denisha Camille Peoples. Sophia Nicole Peppel. Jason Dean Perfader. Owen Timothy Peterson. Zachary Colt Phelps. Pablo Andres Poma Paqui. Matthew Dylan Porter. Brian Kenneth Priest. Shelby Michiko Rosemary Prophet. Jillian Grace Rash. Harrison John Reese. Catherine Marie Reckhoff. Sydney Tate Ripoli. Christopher Michael Retzbach. Ashley Michelle Reyes. Jillian Lee Reinhardt. David Paul Ridenour. Elizabeth Rose Ringer. Fiona Roxanne Ryu. Sydney Alexandra Rivero. Chloe Grace Roberti. Justin Paul Robertson. Thomas Hines Roman. Marcos Sven Romero. Ryland Cecilia Romero Lewis. Ara Paul Rosenhislop. Jenna Nicole Ross. Madeline Wheeler Rothfield. Morgan Elizabeth Rudo. Rachel Robin Rule. Haley Nicole Rumsey. Sophia Catherine Salafia. Lauren Arlene Anayi Sanchez. Hooper G. Sancombe. Amrit Sandhu. Kabir Satija.
Matthew Sherman C. Wright. Jason Michael Shearer. Adam Ni Shi. Kayla Lynn Schreiber. Alexis Karen Shoemate. Yassine Mubashar Siddiqui. Brooke Elizabeth Sills. Robert Joseph Silverman. John Michael Scandalis. Michael Charles Small. Brooke Angelique Smith. Eleanor Jean Smith. Grant McDonald Smith. Catherine Ray Soken. Andrew Joseph Saka. Ellie Elizabeth Spicer. Mitra Blair Spirabilis. Mia Stamatakis. Gabrielle Marie Steinberg. Tristan Michael Stepniak. Anthony Riley Strank. Lydia Lynn Stricker. Matthew Joseph Sturdivant. Tony Emilio Suarez Jr. Benjamin Maxwell Salzer. Zachary Griffin Salzer. Nathan Alexander Swales. Timothy John Sweeney. Garrett James Taylor. Julie Faith Thomas. Matthew Allen Thompson. Catherine J. Thorpe. Charlie Monroe Tribble III. Robert Charles Twig. Raja Baraja Ugwandwa. Arya Brandon Badashur. Lucy Lillian Valor. Edward Nicholas Van Houten Della Russo. Angela Patrice Baseman. Ethan Jonah Vernon. Ashley Marie Vogel. Ethan Michael Waksmunsky. Caitlin Elizabeth Walker. Austin Allen Walls. Jack Egan Walsh. Shane Mitchell Weiss. Brianna Irene Wheeler. Delaney Audrey Williamson. Brian Alexander Wolf. Ryan William Wolfrey. Lauren Elizabeth Wright. Megan Carol Ritt. Michael Zenmei Yang. Harrison Montgomery Craven Young. Justin Eduardo Zamudio. Madison Lee Zell. Liam Coleman Zepp. Nicole Yuwei Zhang.
Congratulations to the class of 2020 on receiving your high school diplomas. The last step is to finally turn your tassels. The gesture of moving your tassel from one side of the cap to the other symbolizes your movement from candidate to graduate. However, before turning our tassels, I would love to pass it over to Maddie for her to offer some thoughts to mark this final step in our graduation.
As cheesy as it sounds, life is short. I mean, come on, look at how fast high school went by. So always remember to stop and enjoy the little things, wherever life takes you. I hope you keep Glenel and the memories you've made here close to your heart. Finally, as you move on to bigger things in a complicated and sometimes confusing world, stay true to who you are. Never lose your sense of self. It is what makes you special and what you are meant to offer the world.
Now the moment you have all been waiting for. Please move your tassel from right to left.
Congratulations, class of 2020.